one of the first things that we need to be able to do is look at cash flows and understand what type of cash flow it is. You with me? So we're going to talk about that here. We're going to talk about operating cash flows, investing cash flows, and financing cash flows. Okay? So that's what I want to do now. We're going to talk about these three different sections. Now, I'm actually going to skip over operating. I'm going to come back to it. Okay? Now, I'm going to tell you, one of the biggest hurdles in teaching students how to do a cash flow statement is getting them to understand this classification of cash flows. Okay? Because really, there are just a ton of different types of cash flows. And there's some really kind of weird ones, too. So what I'm going to do in this session, and as we go through this, is I want to concentrate on the main types of cash flows. We're not going to worry about all these weird things, okay? And this is not much different than when you took accounting one, right? Didn't they teach you the main accounts? But they didn't bring up these weird investments and these weird intangible assets. No, let's walk before we run, right? So I want you to concentrate on learning these main ones. And then as we learn those, then we'll kind of build on it, just like you did in your initial accounting classes, okay? I want to talk to you about the three main type of investing activities, okay? These are the three most common investing cash flows. And when I say classifying cash flows and classifying cash flow activities, it's the same thing. Okay. Buying or selling long-term investments. That is an investing cash flow. So if I buy stock in another company, that's an investing cash flow. Or if I have stock in another company and I sell it, that is an investing cash flow. Are you with me? Okay. Buying or selling fixed assets, such as land, buildings, automobiles, equipment. If I buy a piece of machinery, that is an investing cash flow. If I sell a piece of land, that is an investing cash flow. Okay. Loaning cash on or collecting principal, specify principal, on a long-term note receivable. That is an investing cash flow. Are you with me? Okay. Now, I want you to notice something on these investing cash flows. Okay. I'll go over to the DocuCam. We know our accounting equation is assets equals liabilities plus equity. Is that correct? I want you to notice that at least in your understanding where you are now, these investing cash flows have to do with long-term assets. Okay? At least where you are now, I want you to see that that list that we're going to go back to in a second all have to do with long-term assets. Okay? Let's take a look at it again. Buying or selling long-term investments. Isn't that a long-term asset on your balance sheet? Buying or selling fixed assets, land, building, automobiles, equipment. Those are long-term assets, right? A long-term note receivable, that's a long-term asset. Does that make sense? Okay? So that can kind of guide you in this early stage. Are you with me? Questions on this? Okay? All right. Let's now look at the three most common financing cash flows, okay? Well, issuing long-term debt, including bonds. And when we say like we issue bonds, then we are going into debt, correct? We're talking about that in one of my classes now. Issuing long-term debt, including bonds, or paying principal on that debt. That is a financing cash flow. You with me? Obviously, it's a cash inflow if you're getting a long-term loan. And as you pay off the principal, that's a cash outflow. But they're both financing cash flows. You with me? Issuing stock in your own company is a financing cash flow. Or if you buy back your own stock. Remember treasury stock? Treasury stock is when a company buys back its own stock. Okay? That is a financing cash flow. The other one, The three most common is paying dividends, is a financing cash flow. You with me? Now, if you go back to the doc cam, I want you to see that at least in your understanding of where you are now, that these financing largely have to do with items on the right side of the accounting equation, right? Long-term notes payable, long-term bonds payable, paying dividends on the stock, issuing stock. If we buy back our own stock, it's a contra equity. But all those things have to do with things on this side. Is that correct? So let this be your guide. Long-term assets, investing. Long-term items on this side, financing. You with me? Any questions? Okay. Okay, now let's go back and let's talk about operating. Okay. Now, I want you to, operating are a little bit more difficult to put in a real concise box of what they're going to be. Okay. But operating are the cash flows that occur in our daily operations of our running our business, such as receiving cash from customers. Okay. I'm hopping around on this list. Paying salaries and wages, paying our suppliers, okay? Do you see where these are things that are gonna happen all the time in our operations? I want you to understand when you look back at that investing and financing section, those are things that occur in our business, but they're not really daily operations, right? Do you like buy a big parcel of land all the time for your business? No, you might every now and then. Do you issue stock all the time? Usually not. Usually you have an initial public offering and you may go decades without issuing more stock. Do you buy back treasury stock every day? No. Those are somewhat rare. Even paying dividends is usually only done quarterly. But going back to this operating, do you see where these things have a tendency to be recurring transactions that occur in the daily operations of the business? These are the cash flows that occur in the core business of what we do. Does that make sense? I want you to notice that if you receive interest or pay interest, that is an operating cash flow. That was why I was real specific on those previous slides to say paying principal or collecting principal, right? Because if you ever receive interest or pay interest, it is an operating cash flow. Are you with me? Okay. If you receive dividends, it is an operating cash flow. If you pay dividends, it's a finance. Okay. Again, receipts from customers, salaries and wages, taxes and fines, payments to suppliers, those are all operating cash flows. They occur in the daily operations. Okay. Now I know that this takes a little effort to learn these. But there's just no other way around it. You have to be able to classify your cash flows to be able to prepare a cash flow statement. Okay? Now, I also want to talk about one other thing, and that's kind of a weird deal. But there are some transactions that are called non-cash investing and financing transactions. Okay? For example, you can come off that. Let's say that my company owed your bank $100,000 on a long-term notes payable, okay? Well, what if we decided that you would forgive that debt if I gave you 20,000 shares of stock in my company? Do you see with that transaction, there's no cash that flows either way, is there? You're forgiving the debt, I'm issuing stock. There's no cash flow. But that's a pretty doggone significant transaction. And we have to disclose that separately on the cash flow statement. There's usually a separate note to it that says non-cash, significant non-cash investing and financing transactions. And issuing stock to forgive debt would be one of those. Here's another one. What if I bought a $1 million building completely on credit? Well, what would that journal entry look like? If I bought a $1 million building completely on credit, wouldn't that look like this? I would debit building for $1 million. And then I would credit some toward a long-term notes payable, right? Isn't that the journal entry? Is there any cash coming in or going out here? No. Well, that is another example of a non-cash investing and financing. You need to disclose that separately, okay? Some other ones are going to the computer, leasing of assets, converting preferred stock to common stock. Those are significant enough transactions. What they're trying to do is they don't want people to try to fool the readers, okay? They don't want them to try to fool the readers. And if you forgave a bunch of stock or a bunch of debt by issuing stock, that's something they need to know about. You with me? So how do we learn these transactions? Well, I'm going to show you here, okay? You folks who are watching this, you have this as well. You folks here, you have this. I went ahead and made what can be used as some kind of elementary flashcards, okay? What you can do is cut these out and then fold on the dotted line, and you've got a little set of flashcards. Or if you want, just use this information and copy it on index cards if you want, okay? But I kind of do this for you because it may not be obvious of how to make these flashcards, okay? There should be 4 pages of this. And you can see, for example, purchasing inventory. That's something that's going to happen every day, right? That's an operating activity. Let's look forward. Purchasing land. Well, that's an investing activity, isn't it? Right? We talked about that. It's a long-term asset. Selling a piece of equipment is an investing activity. Let's find a financing one. Paying dividends is a financing one. Issuing stock in our company for cash, that's a financing activity. Okay? Make sense? So, and then you can see I left you a few blank ones if we come up with some others. All right? So you have 2 things that I want you to do before we meet again. I want you to make these flashcards and start learning them. Okay? And then I'm going to give you this, and I'll give you this after. I'll give you folks this after the cameras stop rolling. And for you folks at home, I want you to do the cash flow handout number 1. It's just a few questions and a few homework, if you want to think of it that way, that you need to do that'll get us ready for the next session. Does that make sense? Okay. So this is pretty much it right now. There's like 5 or 6 steps to get where you are now, to get where you can do a cash flow statement, okay? The first thing I need you to do, though, is to start learning those cash flows. Being able to classify those cash flows, okay? So take some time, make those flashcards, mix them up, learn them until you know them. You'll start to see sort of a pattern of them. Like I said, investing have a tendency to be long-term assets. Financing have a tendency to be long-term debt and equity, okay? Operating have a tendency to be things that happen all the time in our daily operations, okay? And non-cash, obviously, are those transactions where if you visualize the journal entry, cash isn't being debited or credited. Cool? So that's what I want you to do. We're done. Start learning those cash flows and do cash flow handout number 1, and I will see you next time, all right? Bring your calculators next time, okay? All right, bye-bye, thanks.